Episode 1613, Chase What Matters.
Moms, needing a little inspiration and a ray of hope? You've come to the right place. This is the show that you can turn to for just the pick-me-up you need. This is Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive.
Happy Happy Day. It is a beautiful day in the neighborhood. Rise and shine. It is Inspiration Motivation Day. Do you have your joy on? Come on, get that smile on your face. Chase what matters. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the K.I.S.S.S. newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. So much happens throughout the day, coming and going in all different directions. But what really has your attention? What is grabbing you? What's grabbing your heart? Chase what matters. When the going gets tough and all the stuff you wish you didn't have, it's got your attention. That's exactly what captures all your thoughts. In fact, so much so that the concerns become problematic worries. These distractions become these huge clouds and rainbows that say, come closer to me. I have so much to give you. But how fair is that to you? How fair is that to your dreams? It doesn't take much in our family to have my head swimming. There's a lot of us. You know, one child needs something while the other requires something totally different. And then I can't discount the ones that aren't even with me. And all of a sudden, my phone's lighting up. Dinner has me scrambling for something to fix. Sound all too familiar? Why am I doing more of something always? Something has got us going in the wrong direction. Most of those somethings are more distractions. It's the stuff that sneaks in between what really matters that has you. Think about it. You become the marionette puppet of distractions. The distractions light up and then you're like, here I am. When I was little, okay, I wasn't that little because I had to be, I believe I was in elementary or early middle school age. And I wanted to do a Paul Revere project. It was for social studies, for history. And I had this crazy idea I want to do puppets. And so my dad was like, well, we can do a marionette. And so we built a marionette together. We made this all out of different dolls and we did our own strings. He even made me this huge marionette stage. We put curtains together. We used that 4 years later. I did a lot of it with children's ministry. But it first started in the classroom of my social studies to fulfill a assignment that I was given. That wasn't a distraction, but eventually, you know, I kind of became that puppet. I was, you know, trying to fill everybody else's dreams, expectations of me. Everybody else was telling me what to do. Do you feel like that's how your life goes? You're that marionette puppet? That one that's just like, I don't know. I don't really feel like I have any control. You do. You have control 100% of your actions. You don't have it of your kid. You don't have it of your husband. Sorry. I know you wish you did, but you don't. You can't control your neighbor. You can't control your best friend. And you definitely cannot control your dog. So the only thing that you can control is you. So why would you give up part of your life to distractions? Take a moment, just take a moment and find the bright side of possibility. Chase what matters. Don't let the dark corners of some things draw you closer. I know it's tempting. Those temptations can be great. So your endurance has got to be stronger. Chase what matters. With each new moment throughout the day, take each thought captive. Be intentional about the direction you want to go. Most of us are just putting out fires. We're answering an email. Oh, we got to put this fire out. The kids are yelling and screaming and having an argument. We got to go put the fire out. Maybe sometimes you literally have to put a fire out. Maybe you left something in the oven. Oh, I've burned some chicken before. And all of a sudden you've got smoke coming out. And you're like, oh my gosh, I let it in there 30 minutes later because you got stuck on a phone call, forgot that the chicken was in the oven. Then what are you having for dinner? Oh, I don't know. I guess I'll run and get some pizza. Oh, no, wait, I'll call Uber Eats and they'll deliver now. Why is our life just literally going in circles? We wake up exhausted. We go to bed exhausted. How fair is that? I mean, answer that question honestly. How fair is that to you? Enough is enough. Chase what matters. Be intentional about what you're going after. Don't sit here and go through life just like, I'm just kind of going on a whim. I don't know. If this happens, I'll respond to it or I'll react to it. Most of us are doing what? We react to everything. Our whole life is about reaction, reaction, reaction. What would happen if you would respond? What would happen if you would actually take aim? Action ignites motivation. Be proactive to what you want in your life. I know you probably woke up a little bit tired today. It's summertime. Maybe you have the luxury of enjoying summertime with your children. You get to stay at home. Maybe you're like, I don't want that luxury. I get to go to work. Either way, whatever you see as a luxury right now, I want you to think about that luxury. What if that luxury was taken away from you in the click of a finger? What would happen? Would it make you rethink, analyze things a little bit differently as to how you go about your day to day? Maybe it might be a phone call from your doctors and they say, I need you to sit down because I have something to tell you. Or maybe it's troubling news on the weekend. Your spouse and you have another argument. But this time, there's no argument. There's just a slammed door and no one coming through it. Unfortunately, those distractions take our heart too. All those distractions, we might think in the moment, we need to take care of it. In the moment, it's a fire that needs to be put out. Yes, there are some things that have to be handled immediately. Some things like going to the bathroom. Some things like maybe brushing our teeth. Some things like eating to stay healthy. Maybe if you have infants, you need to change their diaper. Okay, we get all of that stuff, right? Those are the true nitty-gritty necessities. But what about all the other stuff in between? How much of that is needed? If you were to look at it, what if you just looked at your life and said, okay, where are my responsibilities? Because those responsibilities are somewhat of our have-tos, right? We can't really call them distractions. And so we do have to live up. We have to own those responsibilities and do them, fulfill them. We don't always want to, but we do it anyway. But then it's all the other stuff that falls out of all those other areas. The stuff that you get the phone call that says, hey, girl, I have missed you so. Do you have a minute? And that minute ends up to be 2 hours later. Now, I'm not saying that 2 hours isn't well spent. Don't get me wrong. I love a good girl chat any day. Call me and you'll find out. Send me an email. I would love to speak with you. But sometimes that 2 hours can be spent differently. It can change things. When we chase what matters. You have a dream. You have a purpose in this life. You can go about your day today and just react to everything. You can live out everybody else's wants and needs and forget about yours. But what's going to happen tomorrow? Are you going to press repeat, replay? And keep doing the same thing over and over and over again? Because eventually what? It gets old. And then you are like, I'm getting old. And then you wonder, what's left in this world? I'm old, right? We're just kind of going in this horrible circle. We got to stop the madness. Take the moment today. Captivate your thoughts. Be intentional about the direction you want to go. Run the race you want to win. Chase what matters. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.